Ini.
Halo, bisa dengar suara? Bisa dengar?
Bu Arofiatus mungkin ini apa belakangnya cari yang tembok.
Saya pindah ke mana ya?
Iya.
Oke, coba Pak. Tes, tes. Oke, tes, tes, satu, dua. Sudah. Oke, tes, tes, satu, dua. Mas, sudah? Oh, bisa masuk. Sudah masuk, Pak. Nah, kalau mati semua harusnya harusnya enggak feedback, harusnya loh. Coba. Kenapa ya, Bu ya?
Kok nggak bisa ya?
Ya, Bu, kalau tidak bisa nggak usah pakai full dokter, nggak apa-apa.
Oke.
Gitu.
Oke, tes tes satu dua.
Masih mendengar.
Tes tes satu dua. Saya kan nggak ini. Oh, anu Bu, suaranya dikecilkan aja.
Oh, iya.
Suaranya dikecilkan. Nggak pengaruh itu Pak, asli nih Pak. Suaranya dikecilkan Bu. Oke. Ya. Tes tes satu dua. Tuh, aman kan?
Oke.
Ya. Jadi Bu Nana juga. Oh, karena Bu Nana pakai headset, sedangkan Bu Santi kan tidak pakai headset.
Tes, tes, satu, dua, masuk, ya?
Ya, Bapak. Kita mulai, Bapak. Jam 9, Mas. Ya. Ayo, Bu, dimulai, Bu. Bismillah. Anu, kalau materinya suruh matikan aja, Pak. Suruh matikan.
Virtual background. Cek. Baik, assalamualaikum. Assalamualaikum. Waalaikumsalam. Untuk Pak Afrianto mungkin bisa untuk virtual background-nya bisa dimatikan saja, tidak apa-apa, Pak.
Oke. Siap.
Baik. Kita mulai. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning. Oh, ternyata belum diadmit dulu. Video freeze.
Monggo dimulai. Cek sound semuanya peserta sudah oke?
Siap.
Cek sound.
Siap.
Siap, siap.
Siap, siap, siap.
Bahasa Inggris ya, benar bahasa Inggris.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning. I wish you in a good shape today. The Honorable Director of Nahdlatul Ulama Sunan Giri Bojonegoro University, the Honorable Vice Rector 1 and Vice Rector 2, the Honorable the Deans, the Head of Departments, the Lecturers at UNU Giri Bojonegoro, the Honorable our presenters of today's webinar, Bapak Afrianto Daud, PhD, and Ibu Arofiatu Sadia, MPD, and all the participants from Zoom and YouTube channel. I'm April will be the host of this webinar. Ladies and gentlemen, ELT in EFL setting has always been an interesting topic for scholars, researchers, and also teachers. The dynamically changing issues in ELT make it an everlasting topic to address. One of the most popular and well-discussed issues is how to create an innovative and impactful English learning. Within this pandemic era, how we approach the notion? As a teacher, how can we engage the students in a virtual setting? And as a student, school or university student, how to best learn English from home? Ladies and gentlemen, we warmly welcome you to today's webinar addressing the previous issues under the title Creative and Innovative English Learning in New Normal Era. To begin with, let's start the day with prayers. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Next, we will listen to our national anthem, Indonesia Raya and Mars Subhanul Watan.
Bangkitlah, hai bangsaku. siapa datang mengancammu, kan binasa di bawah dirimu.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now we will listen to the opening remark by Director of Unugiri Bojonegoro. For Bapak Dr. Haji Muhammad Ridwan Hambali, LCMA, time is yours. Bapak, mohon maaf, bisa dinyalakan dulu? Masih mute?
Oke, saya tekan-tekan nggak bisa ya. Tadi kayaknya ada yang menghalangi itu. Alhamdulillah sudah bisa nggih. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillah walhamdulillah wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wala haula wala quwata illa billah amma ba'du. Yang terhormat. Suaranya lambat nggih. Transferring-nya lambat nggih.
Iya Bapak.
Lambat ya suaranya.
Ini mungkin bisa mencari tempat. Iya Bapak, sinyalnya merah.
Oh gitu. Waduh. Kalau lambat itu enggak menarik, jadi enggak bisa responsif nanti, enggak bisa langsung diterima dengan cepat gitu. Tapi enggak apa-apalah ya. Mudah-mudahan seiring berjalannya waktu sinyalnya akan semakin kuat. Yang terhormat Bapak narasumber kita, Pak Afrianto Daud, PhD.
Ya, assalamualaikum. Selamat,
ya, selamat datang Pak Afrianto ke Unugiri. Sekarang kita masih pandemi, jadi mungkin kita ketemu secara daring, secara dalam jaringan. Ya. Insya Allah di kesempatan yang akan datang kita akan ketemu Bapak dalam suasana luring, insya Allah.
Amin.
Saya pagi ini sedikit beda penampilan saya. Mungkin kalau kawan-kawan ditanya, loh Pak Rektor kok penampilannya beda? Saya biasanya tidak pernah meninggalkan songkok, Pak Afrianto.
Oh.
Iya, begitu saya melihat Pak narasumber kita, Pak Afrianto, sama dengan saya, botak. Jadi saya kemudian melepaskan songkok. Mudah-mudahan ini menjadi kesamaan yang baik ya, Pak Afrianto ya.
Iya, iya.
Selamat datang sekali lagi di Unugiri. Yang terhormat Ibu narasumber kita yang kedua, Ibu Arofiatus Sa'diyah, MPD. Selamat datang Bu Arofiatus Sa'diyah.
Baik Pak, selamat pagi. Assalamualaikum.
Yes, salam. Sama Ibu, selamat ketemu secara daring. Insya Allah di kesempatan yang akan datang kita mudah-mudahan bisa ketemu secara offline, secara luring Ibu ya.
Amin.
Ibu Dekan FKIP, Ibu MPD, Bapak Kaprodi sekarang ganti Pak Kaprodi kita, Bapak Pak Tony, seluruh jajaran tenaga pendidik yang ada di PPI, saya ucapkan selamat dan sukses atas terselenggaranya kegiatan ini. Seluruh peserta dari baik yang dari internal Unugiri maupun dari eksternal Unugiri, ya kalau saya lihat di partisipannya ada sekitar sudah hampir 100-an, jadi 97 atau 98 yang sudah gabung secara daring. Tapi insya Allah secara streaming kita juga menyiarkan ini dan infonya sudah 1.000 lebih yang mengikuti kegiatan ini. Ini satu kebanggaan, satu kepercayaan dari masyarakat, dari para peserta kepada kami, di mana kami sebagai penyelenggara atau sebagai pelaksana pendidikan di Universitas Nahdlatul Ulama Sunan Giri Bojonegoro ingin terus memberikan pelayanan yang terbaik. Kami ingin mendapat feedback dari kawan-kawan yang ada di luar, bagaimana penyelenggaraan pendidikan kami, khususnya yang berkaitan dengan pendidikan atau prodi pendidikan bahasa Inggris. Saya, kami semuanya yakin dan percaya prodi ini prodi yang bagus, prodi yang baik. Saya yakin kalau ini dikembangkan dengan baik, insya Allah akan diminati oleh banyak orang. Saya mau ngomong seperti Bu Santi saja enggak bisa saya. Jadi nanti harus kursus sama Bu Santi kelihatannya ini.
Iya, Bapak.
Mohon maaf Bapak Ibu narasumber ya. Jadi lejahnya, lahjahnya, lahjah itu apa istilahnya? Logat atau lisannya masih lisan Jawa. Walaupun saya lama di luar negeri tapi ya begitu, urdal gradul gitu. Enggak pede lah kalau mau ngomong langsung di depan kawan-kawan yang memang tiap hari ngomongnya bahasa Inggris, yaitu kawan-kawan yang ada di pendidikan atau prodi pendidikan bahasa Inggris. Saya yakin insya Allah Unugiri bersama dengan para narasumber kita dalam kegiatan yang saya yakin menarik dan bermanfaat ini akan memberikan banyak sumbangsih, akan memberikan banyak manfaat kepada kita semuanya, khususnya yang ada di PBI dan umumnya kita semuanya yang ada di Civitas Akademika Unugiri. Harapan kami dari Bapak dan Ibu narasumber, monggo mohon ilmunya, pengalamannya dicurahkan ke kami semuanya, bagaimana kita bisa berkreatif, bagaimana kita berinovasi kaitannya dengan English learning. Harus bagaimana sih supaya anak-anak kita ini bisa betul-betul begitu keluar dari PBI, dari S1 PBI, dia keluar langsung bisa ngomong bahasa Inggris, itu caranya bagaimana? Mungkin yang kurang sekarang ini kita melakukan pendekatan-pendekatan secara konkret dengan pihak-pihak yang memang tiap hari atau tiap waktu selalu ngomong dengan menggunakan bahasa Inggris. Saya pernah mengusulkan kepada Pak Kop, Ibu Kemungkinan yang sekarang, tempat itu mendorong atau menciptakan satu atmosfer setiap hari ngomong bahasa Inggris. Mungkin bisa ke orang-orang yang kelasnya adalah orang kuliah, atau mungkin ke lembaga-lembaga yang secara ketat gitu mewajibkan masyarakat atau komunitasnya untuk berbahasa Inggris. Saya kira hal-hal seperti itu perlu dilakukan. Tapi kaitannya dengan era new normal ini penting sekali, bagaimana di situasi yang pandemi ini anak-anak kita tetap kreatif, yang penting sekali. Mohon nanti Bapak Ibu narasumber memberikan masukan-masukan, arahan atau sharing pengalaman paling tidak ke depan bagaimana kita menyiapkan anak-anak kita supaya anak-anak kita juga tetap konsisten dengan bahasa Inggrisnya. Saya kira begitu harapan dari kami. Selamat datang Bapak Ibu narasumber dan lulusan kampus Universitas Nahdlatul Ulama Sunan Giri Bojonegoro. Tentu ada banyak kekurangan terkait dengan jaringan dan sebagainya, kami mohon maaf ya, karena memang begitulah, kita tidak bisa maksimal kalau menggunakan daring ini. Ya, tapi mudah-mudahan fasilitas yang ada, sarana yang ada, kita bisa manfaatkan semaksimal mungkin. Saya kira begitu dari saya, dengan ucapan bismillahirrahmanirrahim, kegiatan webinar dengan tema Creative and Innovative English Learning in New Normal Era pada tanggal 28 September 2020 secara resmi saya nyatakan buka. Kurang lebihnya saya mohon maaf. Wallahul muwaffiq ila aqwamit thoriq. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Baba, for the insightful speech for us here. Next, we will have... Okay, Baba?
Ya, Nuwun Sewu, saya mohon izin karena saya harus ke sidang skripsi. Mohon izin, Bapak Ibu Narasumber, okay?
Terima kasih.
Sama-sama. Monggo dilanjut. Insya Allah nanti di penutupan barangkali saya akan gabung lagi. Ini ada sidang skripsi. Mohon maaf. Ya. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Next, we will have the Dean of Teacher Training and Education Faculty for the next speech for Ibu Astrid Chandrasari, MPD. The time is yours. I'm sorry, Bu Astrid, can you unmute your microphone, please? We cannot hear you. Halo. Yes, thank you.
Okay. Tadi sudah tak klik sama kayak Pak Rektor. Belum diizinkan. Baik, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin, wabihi nasta'in, ala umuri dunya wadin. Assalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ajma'in amma ba'du. Yang terhormat Bapak Rektor Dr. Haji Muhammad Ridwan Hambali LCMA, Bapak Warek 1 Dr. Nurul Huda MHI, Ibu Warek 2 Dr. Hajah Ifa Khairiyah Ningrum SEMM, dan pemateri Bapak Afrianto Daud PhD, Ibu Arofiatus Sa'diyah MPD, dan Kaprodi PBI Bapak Muhammad Fatoni MPD serta panitia, dosen dan dekan tamu undangan semuanya, peserta webinar yang dirahmati Allah. Selamat datang Bapak Afrianto dan Ibu Arofiatus. Tadi sudah disambut sama Pak Rektor. Yeah. Tadi sudah disambut sama Pak Rektor, saya juga ingin menyambut, yeah, Pak. Karena senang sekali bisa kehadiran oleh narasumber dari jauh-jauh, Bapak dari Riau nih, yeah, Pak. Selamat datang di Kampus Wonogiri, Pak. Harapan kami nggak suatu saat nanti bisa datang secara langsung ke Kampus Wonogiri. Begitu pula dengan Ibu Arofiatus. Kalau Bu Arofiatus ini dekat saja, Bu, ya, dari Malang.
Dari Malang.
Ya, sekali waktu bisa mampir ke Wonogiri, Bu. Pojoknya pojoknya Jawa Timur, Bojonegoro.
Iya.
Oke, alhamdulillah ini saya sangat senang sekali dapat ada narasumber yang mau bersedia memberikan materi jauh-jauh dari Riau. Kami juga ada dosen ini dari Padang, Bu Iin. Mungkin hari ini juga mengikuti walaupun beliau ini sedang cuti hamil. Hmm. Saya dari PBI ini ada yang paling jauh, Bapak, dari Padang.
Oh, oke, ya.
Kemudian saya ingin mengucapkan juga selamat datang pada para peserta webinar. Kemarin saya dapat laporan dari kaprodinya Pak Fatoni bahwa pesertanya sudah hampir, bukan hampir ya, sudah mencapai 1000. Alhamdulillah, cuman saya lihat di Zoom kali ini partisipannya baru 99. Oke, okay, saya rasa mungkin pada ini ya menyaksikannya di YouTube.
Ya.
Itu alhamdulillah.
Karena 100 orang.
Oh, enggak, Bapak. Oh iya, 100 orang. Alhamdulillah. Kemudian karena ini, Pak, saya tertarik karena pesertanya ini banyak sekali dari luar Jawa. Mungkin beberapa ini teman-teman masih bingung ya, ini universitasnya di mana. Mungkin saya akan memperkenalkan sedikit Universitas Nahdlatul Ulama Sunan Giri, Bojonegoro, khususnya di fakultas saya. Jadi PBI ini tergabung dalam Fakultas Keguruan dan Ilmu Pendidikan. Prodinya di FKIP sendiri itu ada 4. Yang pertama Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris, Pendidikan Jasmani Kesehatan dan Rekreasi, kemudian ada Pendidikan Matematika, dan satu lagi adalah Bimbingan dan Konseling. Harapan saya mungkin dari Bapak Afrianto dan Bu Rofiatus dan para peserta webinar, ada yang dari universitas dimanapun, kami berharap bisa saling jalin komunikasi dan MOU, kerjasama dan lain sebagainya. Semoga terus tersambung silaturahminya.
Amin.
Harapan saya acara hari ini berjalan dengan lancar, dan ilmu yang didapatkan dapat bermanfaat bagi kita semua. Amin. Saya rasa demikian, Bu Santi. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Bu Astrid, for the powerful motivation for us here. Well, ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, our head of department, English Education Department, will send us a warm welcome and mention some important things regarding this webinar. For Bapak Muhammad Fatoni, SPD, MPD, time is yours.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Honorable Mr. Ridwan Hamali as Director of Undugiri Bojonegoro, Mr. Nurul Huda and Ms. Iva Khoirianingrum as the Vice Rector of Undugiri Bojonegoro, Honorable Ms. Astrid Chandrasari as the Dean of Teacher and Education Faculty. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Muhammad Fatoni, the Head of English Education Department of Undugiri Bojonegoro. Thank you for joining our webinar entitled Creative and Innovative English Learning in New Normal Era. Before we get started, I would like to express my appreciation to the webinar crew who generously help us to make this webinar come true. In our webinar, we have two speakers, Mr. Aprianto Daud, PhD, and also Ms. Arofiatus Sadia. Okay, Mr. Aprianto, we are going to discuss about the creative and innovative English learning in new normal era. And Ms. Arofiatus Sadia is going to discuss about experiencing learning English in Europe. There are 100 something participants. It is a very great numbers, I think, for this webinar. And I hope we get knowledge and also the information about the learning English in the new normal era. Okay, welcome and enjoy our webinar, this webinar, and thank you. Okay, now for the host, the floor is yours.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, Pak Tony, for the support for us here. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to announce the rules of this webinar and how you will get the e-certificates. So please switch off your device into muted mode during the session, and the chat box will be activated few minutes before the presenters and the talk. You are invited to write questions in the chat box through Zoom or comment box in YouTube using the format. You can use hashtag ASK and then / participant name and then your affiliation and your question. You can also ask the presenters live by click the raise hand feature for you who joined through Zoom. The exit ticket will be launched at the end of the session and will automatically be closed by the server after 2 hours. Complaints will only be responded during that time. And materials from the presenters will be available and accessible on our website, pbe.unugiri.ac.id or unugiri.ac.id. And the webinar session will also be streamed via YouTube channel Unugiri TV. And how we will get the e-certificate? So the exit ticket will serve as the attendance list, and the link to the exit ticket will be distributed near the end of the webinar via Zoom chat, WhatsApp group, and YouTube comments. The link for exit ticket is open within 2 hours only until 2 p.m. Jakarta time. The e-certificate will be automatically generated by system right after you completed the exit ticket and sent to your email by system within 5 or 10 minutes. And make sure you fill the name and your email correctly. Complaint related to exit ticket and e-certificate will be answered until 3 p.m. Jakarta time. Otherwise, your complaint will not be responded. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we approach to the main session of this webinar. We have two outstanding presenters today. We have Bapak Aprianto Daud, PhD, and Ibu Arofiatus Sadia, MPD, on the line. We will soon listen to the presentation from Bapak Aprianto Daud, PhD, first, and then followed by Q&A session, question and answer session. So if you have any questions, you may write it down in chat room or comment box in YouTube channel few minutes before the first presenter and the talk. And we will start to activate the chat room for you. Ladies and gentlemen, to know Bapak Afrianto Daud PhD more, we will watch the video profile.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Oke. Okay. Halo, Bu. Should I go ahead?
Assalamualaikum, Bapak.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi. Yap. Okay.
Wait a minute.
Halo Mbak Santi.
Are you with us?
Yeah. Hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
The time is yours, Bapak.
All right, thank you. Baik. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yeah, good morning everyone. Alhamdulillah, syadalah ilaha illallah wa sallallahu Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa nabi ba'da. The honorable Rektor of Universitas Nahdlatul Ulama Wonogiri Sunan Giri, sorry, and then all deputy rectors and dean of Faculty of Teachers Training and Education, head of department, all colleagues from Wonogiri, and all participants. So thank you for having me for this webinar. I'm very happy to be part of you today. All right, now let me share my screen first. Can you now see my screen, Bu Santi?
Yes, sir. Yes, right. Very clearly.
Okay. So in the next 30 minutes, I'm going to share some ideas how to create English learning as our theme of webinar today. And I think most of the ideas that I'm going to share with you is based on my practice in my class. So that's why I'm also inviting some of my students to join this webinar. I will probably show you how I practice some ideas in the real classroom later. Okay. However, they cannot join in Zoom room because of the quota, I think. So they are now, some of them are now live in YouTube streaming. Okay. this way, it's a bit lagging here. So about me, it has been introduced by our moderator, and I think I'm really impressed of how you manage this webinar. It's really well managed, and my CV has been managed in video, and I think that's really good and creative way of introducing a presenter. So when we are talking about creativity today, you have done that part of creativity in introducing the speaker. So well done, webinar crew. Okay. So everyone, we all know that we are not living in what we call by new normal era because of COVID-19. COVID-19 has limited our life now. We cannot go to school, for example. Our school building are now closed and we have to switch massively to online learning. So simply we can say that online learning during this COVID-19 is a must. It's no longer a choice. So we are not now discussing that we are not ready yet or something, but the question is how can we be ready with this situation? Because online learning is a must. That is now the most possible way to reach our students. So that's why our webinar today is, we are talking about how to be creative and innovative teachers or innovative learning during this new normal. Most of the time I'm going to discuss about this topic in the context of online learning. And I think this is an interesting quote. I got it from a friend posted in Facebook. We said that school buildings are closed. Yes, that's true. But remember that schools are actually not closed. Yeah, because the teachers and staff today are working harder than ever. So do you agree with this quote? I think we can feel that, yes, I think I myself agree with this quote that today as teachers, we are now living in, what is it, in more challenging situation, not to say more difficult, but more challenging situation. And one of the reasons is because we have to switch massively, intensively to online learning mode. So we are now working harder. But at the same time, actually, it's not only the teachers are now working harder. Yeah, you can see from these pictures that, yeah, you know, students are also working much harder. Even online learning can put more burdens for students. Look at these two pictures. What do you think about these two pictures? Do you think, is it the ideal situation of online learning from the side of students? You see that these students, you know, they have lots of things to do, okay? And look at their face, look at their faces. Do you think they are happy? I don't think they are happy. Yeah, they're not happy because of too much assignments, too much projects, for example, from teachers. Because the phenomenon, especially in early switch to online learning because of some reasons, for example, the teachers don't know how to conduct online learning. Some students simply, you know, post or simply send assignments home or simply post assignments through WhatsApp group, for example. And there are a lot of assignments students must do. And then at the end of the day, of course, yeah, this can, you know, this situation can make our students not happy or maybe stressful at the end of the day. And of course, this is not the situation that what we want, right? So now the question is how to be creative teachers during this pandemic? Yeah, how can we make our students happy again? Okay. So let's now discuss about this topic. Yeah, I will begin by showing this framework to you all that when we are conducting online learning, these are the things that we need to have in general. Of course, we need to have what we call by hardware. Yeah, it can be personal computer, it can be smartphone, it can be iPad and things like that. It's about hardware, it's about gadgets, right? And of course, we have to have what we call by content, digitalization. Yeah, because we cannot see our student in offline mode. So of course we cannot use paper-based or paper-based materials. So we have to switch to digitalized content. It can be e-module, it can be e-text, it can be audio, it can be video or e-simulation, okay? And to enable this content delivered well to student, we need to have what we call by LMS or learning management system. Okay, if you have online learning system already in your campus or in your school, that's good, all right? However, if you don't have this LMS yet in your campus or in your school, yeah, we can actually use some free platform. Yeah, in our campus, for example, we are still constructing, we are still building our own LMS, but because it's not ready yet, now most of the time we use Google Suite for Education. Of course, it's not the only one LMS. There are other platforms like Moodle or Edmodo and some others. But my point is, it is very important for us to make sure that we have one learning management system as a place for us to manage all activities during this online platform. I mean, this online learning. Okay. So choose one that best for you. Yeah, Google Classroom, for example. So later you can manage all this content or this digitalized learning media. And of course, we need an internet network. Yeah, there is a problem here because, you know, we have what we call by digital divide problem in Indonesia. In some areas, the internet connection is good, but in other part of Indonesia, still is not that good. It's not as good as Java Island, for example. Okay. So we are talking about online learning. This is another thing that we have to consider. And of course, later we have to think of how can we conduct that. It is about methodology or about a teaching methods. Okay. So all of these things, I think, need to be taken into account when we are discussing how can we conduct creative and innovative learning in the context of pandemic. So to make it sure, there are 3 M that we have to do, everyone, to create an innovative and creative online learning, yeah, especially in learning English. That's what I say, what I'm saying by 3 M. Yeah, the first M is about media, and the next one is method and materials. What I mean by these 3 M is we have first to find the most effective media for our teaching, and there are a lot of media available, and some media are probably good for our student, but maybe some are not. It is us as teachers, of course, that who knows well what is our student situation, for example. So find the most effective media and then decide the most effective method for your online learning. Okay. We're talking about method, for example, yeah, in general, there are 2 methods of online learning. It's called by synchronous and asynchronous method. Synchronous is when you have real-time interaction with your students, like having video conference today, but it doesn't have to be video conference all the time because there are some problem with video conference. Can be about connection, can be about quota. You know, some students are living in rural area, for example. So you can find another method, what we call by asynchronous method. So you put media and you can upload your teaching material in your learning management system, for example, and student can do and can work with the materials whenever they are ready and whenever they are connected to the internet, for example. And there are some other methods, of course, but my point is, you know what would be the most effective method for your class, considering your student situation. And in the context of creativity, I think you need to also to create your own teaching materials today. Yeah, you can create from zero. Yeah, what is it? 100% creating your own material, or you can do what we call by ATM. Yeah, amati, tiru, and modifikasi. Yeah, you can take some materials from YouTube, for example, and then you modify a bit, and then you develop your new material based on what you have seen from YouTube, for example. So my point is, this is the time for us also to challenge ourselves to create your own teaching materials. I'm sorry for some misspelling there. And then also find the most suitable learning resources for your students' learning. And we are now living in difficult situation. Yeah, there are physical distancing. We must wear masks and we cannot go to our normal classroom. But the good thing also, alhamdulillah, we are not living in digital era. We are most of us now connected to the internet, and there are lots of learning resources available in the internet that you can use. So in terms of resources, I think today we are lucky. Yeah, we can explore the internet, for example, to find our learning resources. And I'm going to talk more about this topic later. This is one small example that I'm doing for myself. So after pandemic, for example, I'm trying to activate my YouTube channel. So I use my YouTube channel as one of the media, one of the platforms that can be used for my learning activity. So I sometimes record my explanation and using, of course, video recording, and I edit my video and then I upload it into YouTube channel, and then later I can share the link of the materials in my LMS. In this case, it's Google Classroom. So we don't have to see our student face-to-face all the time, okay? We can simply create our own video and then upload it into our, again, our YouTube, and then share the link later through LMS or through WhatsApp group. That is the, I think, the simplest platform that we can use to reach our students at the moment. However, we have to consider this issue when we are deciding which media is good for our students. Yeah, there are some media, what we call by high-tech media. High-tech media means that media that can, you know, use our bandwidth and high bandwidth. It would be high quota, lots quota used, like Zoom, Google Meet, WebEx, Skype, Eagle Live, YouTube Live, and so on and so forth. All video-based media would be high bandwidth. So if we think that our students now are dealing also with economic problem, we need to be wise in this case. Do not use Google Meet, do not use Zoom all the time, okay? But these are some alternatives. So at the same time, there are some low-tech media or low-bandwidth media that we still can use to reach our students. Yeah, we can sometimes use our SMS using our phone, for example. Google Classroom is part of low-bandwidth, I think, as far as you don't upload too much video there. Yeah, we can also use Google Doc, or you can use WhatsApp, you can use Telegram. Yeah, if you don't know Telegram yet, Telegram is kind of WhatsApp, but the good thing of Telegram is the member can be thousands of members in one group, unlike WhatsApp. WhatsApp is only limited to 250 people, right? Okay, you also use Mentimeter, you can use Blog, yeah, one of the medias that you can use to teach your students, especially writing. You still can use email and some other media. Next, I'm going to show you some recommended platforms or apps or web-based learning resources that we can use for our English learning. Okay, so I'm going to show you some, and I will probably also later invite my student to participate. Okay. The first app that is highly recommended for us to use at the moment is this one, Google Suite for Education, or it used to be Google Apps for Education. This is especially the case if you don't have your own learning management system. I highly recommend you to use Google Classroom. It's free, yeah, especially if we come from a formal educational institution, your school can register for an account in G Suite for Education. And I found this LMS is really useful. It's really handy to manage my class online. You can do a lot of things here, okay? So this one, learning management system that I think recommend for you, if you are not familiar, you can learn how to use Google Classroom. There are a lot of tutorial in YouTube. You can see later how to use it. Allow me to show you only one or two activities that we can do in Google Classroom. So I have been using this Google Classroom long time before pandemic. So this way. But it's a good thing to see that more teachers now getting more familiar with Google Classroom. This is good. Okay. So this is only still talking about how you manage your class. This is not yet specific to English, actually. So using Google Classroom, I found it, what is it? We can do almost everything that we need as teachers and students there in Google Classroom. When you want to reach your student, let's say when you want to inform something, if you want to put an announcement, for example, you can simply put your announcement here in the streamline, and your students can get the notification immediately in their gadget. Yeah, assuming that they have installed this Google Classroom in their mobile devices, for example. Yeah, just like what I did this morning. Yeah, this is actually the first semester in our campus because of the schedule that I have in my campus is almost overlapping with our schedule today. And this is what I did in my class this morning. Dear student, welcome to my class. Hope you are all doing well. For our first meeting today, please join my webinar, blah, blah, blah. Okay, you can enter as participant. And then look at my the responses from my students. They can respond immediately, okay? And there is a feature here that we can use this classwork. This is a place for us to upload our materials, to upload quiz, to upload assignment, also to have attendance list, for example. Yeah, you can do it here. And you can see your student here, how many students join with your class. You can just simply click there. Yeah, so I have 36 students here. And later, if I have graded my student assignment, all grades will be seen here. But this is a new class. There is no grade yet, of course. So there's nothing here at the moment, okay? Okay, now I'm going to practice. I'm going to show you how can you create attendance form, for example, as a proof of attendance. So you can simply create attendance form here by using Google Form, because the good thing of Google Classroom is it's already integrated to all other Google's application like Google Form, Google Doc, as a Google Slide, as well as YouTube. Okay, so for example, today I'm going to ask my student to sign their attendance, because you know, in online teaching, sometimes our campus or our schools need some proof, yeah, to prove to the administration or administration office that we have conducted our class, and then they need some proof, okay? And we can do this a kind of proof using Google Form and Google Classroom. For example, let's call it attendance form, and you can simply write their name here. And then make sure you have required. So student must write their name, unless otherwise they cannot submit the form, and then copy. And then what else? Like student register number. Or name. And then I normally also ask students to sign signature. You know, only these three things, I think, the most important information in attendance form, right? Signature. So because they cannot do it offline, so they can do it digitally. So we use here upload. So they can have the specimen of their signature and photo the signature and later crop it, edit a bit, and then later upload the signature here. So all students, if you are now listening to me, I'm now posting this attendance form to our class. Please sign the attendance form, okay, to prove that you are attending in my class. Okay, now my students should have got the notification in Google Classroom. Okay, as you can see, this is the attendance form, and later we can see how many students have signed the attendance form. And also the good thing of this Google Classroom is you can also create Meet link here. So it will be integrated automatically with your Google Classroom. So what is Meet link? It's the link for your Google Meet, everyone. Google Meet is a Google product, just like Zoom. Okay. So later, your student can simply click the link here. So it has been generated at the moment. So when you ask your student to join your class face-to-face interaction like here, like today, you can ask them, okay, class, now let's meet in our Google Meet. Yeah, I will wait for you there in 5 minutes, for example. So later you and they can simply click the link and the link will bring you to Google Meet application. Again, what is Google Meet? Is that is the video conference product from Google, just like Zoom. And what is the good thing of Google Meet? Okay, for Zoom, if it is only a free account, it's only limited to 40 minutes, right? In Google Meet, especially when you have G Suite for Education, this is unlimited. So you can use it for free and you can use for synchronous or video conference class, just like Zoom, for unlimited time. So now it's now connecting to my camera. Okay, but because of my camera is now being used for this Zoom, probably it's not going to work. So later you can just jump here. So you can join to your class and now you can wait your student here. Okay, that's only a bit of Google Classroom, everyone. Of course, I'm not going to show you everything about Google Classroom, but my point is this is highly recommended learning management system that we can use for free now. Yeah, for free again. All right, and another web-based application that we can use for our class, and this is especially now I'm going to show you an example of English learning, that's called Edpuzzle, everyone. So Edpuzzle is a web that you can use to engage your students through video, okay? Through video. And this is a good application. This is a good web for especially for listening activity. Okay, I'll show you how to use Edpuzzle now. You can create a free account in edpuzzle.com, and I have made my free account. I'll show you how to use it. Moderator, just remind me how many minutes left. Yeah. Okay. Here, this is Edpuzzle, everyone. So to create the account, that's easy. Just follow the normal procedure of creating an account in internet, right? So now this is my account. And later, when you have created an account, it shows your institution here, and it shows your content here. And you can integrate with your class in Google Classroom. This is the good thing of Edpuzzle. So when you have material here, you can integrate your Google Classroom. So your student can simply member of your class here. So in the context of English learning, for example, so I click my content. And this is a good video, for example, how to teach kids about COVID-19 using BrainPop. This is a video that we can get from searching in the content here, and it can link to Edpuzzle or YouTube or Khan Academy. So in this case, I got it from Edpuzzle databases. So you can ask your student to listen to this short video, and they can do some activities here as a quiz. So they listen to the video and answer the questions. Yeah, after, for example, in 54 seconds, there will be a quiz. The quiz can be used from the quiz made from other teachers, But later you can also edit the video and you can create your own quiz. Yeah. So I'll play this video, for example.
Nothing like an early morning jog.
Okay, I will jump to this bit.
Coronaviruses okay. are one group named for their crown-shaped outline. Four of these.
This is the quiz. So after part of the video, there is a quiz that your student can do. So how many different types of coronavirus can infect human? So your student can later answer, for example, 4, and they can submit their answer, and the quiz later will automatically decide whether it is one is it true or not. You know, in this case, it's true. If it is true, they can continue.
A lot of times when you get a cold, it's okay. caused by a coronavirus.
So again, I can't show you details of this at puzzle.com, but at least I've taught the idea of at puzzle. So at puzzle is learning media video. So you can use it for your listening class especially, and you can easily search any topics that you need in this at puzzle. Yeah, using the search engine button here. So now I'll enough with that. And then another web-based material that is really interesting for me is this one, News in Level. So for this web, News in Levels, you can use it for listening activity. And the good thing is this activity also integrated with reading activity, also vocabulary development, as well as speaking practice. So the material there start from listening, and then later there will be a text for reading, and there will be some vocabulary activities. And if your student want to develop or want to explore more of the activities in this News in Level, they can create their Skype account, and then they can keep contact with some other students from all over the world, register in this News in Level. So they can have like further activity to explore or to have more practice with some other students in other part of the world. And I think this is gonna be very interesting for your student if you use this as your learning materials. Now I'm showing you. Yeah, you can choose, of course, depending on your student level. Now let me choose the basic level, right? Level 1, for example, this one. So you can click this level 1. Okay, so This is the video. Now let's listen to the video. Yeah, this is a free website. Sometimes there are some ads. Yeah, so let's listen to the video first. Please wait, I change the level now. And then choose the information. Yeah, this is the reading activity, right? And the highlight one is for vocabulary, okay? And this is the listening activity.
On Monday, researchers detected evidence that may suggest that microbes are living in sulfuric clouds in the atmosphere
of Venus. Yeah, hope you hear the video.
Studied the clouds from telescopes in Hawaii.
So this is the listening activity. This is the reading activity. And later you can adjust the level. Yeah, of course, the higher the level, the more complicated the reading content. And there are some activities more that they can do later. Yeah, as the what is it? Yeah, like this. What do you think about this news, for example? And there is a test after that. Yeah. So explore this website, everyone, as one of alternative for you to for your learning resources. Okay, now I come back to my presentation. Are you still with me, by the way?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. All right. Another website that I found really useful for your learning resources, everyone. This one, Learning English Hits, developed by British Council. And there are a lot of interesting materials already developed by British Council that you can use as an alternative for your learning resources. It can be for listening. Yeah, there are a lot of songs there, as well as movies, short stories. There are some material for reading and writing. And I suggest you to explore this website as well. Okay. There are also some activities for grammar and vocabulary, and also some fun games. Okay. Some fun games. Okay. How many minutes left, Ibu Santi?
Yeah, I think we still have 5 more minutes, sir.
Okay. All right. Okay, let me show you this web. Maybe some of you have been familiar with this web. Because the problem of some teachers is it's too difficult for us now to have the material, sir, because of pandemic, we cannot give our student the book or the textbook. Yeah, you don't have to think about textbook at the moment because you can use online learning resources. Of course, you have to choose which one is appropriate for your student level. So if you are teaching kids, for example, I think this is a good learning resources. Learning English Kids, British Council. Yeah, look, this is a well-managed website. And is developed by an official institution, British Council. Everybody knows about British Council, right? And look, this is for listening activity, listen and watch. Okay, this is for reading and writing. This is spoke speaking and spelling, like sound or spelling. And this is about grammar and vocabulary. Yeah, and also some fun games. You can also have a print and make like flashcard here. Okay. So I'll show you one activity, for example, for spelling. Okay. So you can click this link if you want to use that, the Spelling Sports Day. Yeah, it takes a bit longer because of the network. Okay, this is the video for spelling. So what Sam and Pam have fun.
It was a sunny summer's day. Sam and Pam followed Tess and Ben to the fields. It was sports day at Tess and Ben's school. The children were sitting and chatting, waiting for the races to begin.
So this material can be used to teach spelling.
First,
ending by ing, at NLY or Lee. Okay, loudly, for example. So you can ask your student to pay attention to this particular ending.
And some children were running slowly.
Running.
I do apologize, sir. I'm afraid that this webinar will be taken down by the YouTube if you try to play a video from online website, sir.
Sorry?
Yeah, I am afraid that this webinar will be taken down by YouTube because you play a video online from the internet, sir. So I think just skip it. Yeah. I'm sorry.
That's fine. Okay. But I'm showing you in the context of teaching, right? Okay. All right, everyone. So maybe my last bit is, yeah, there's another web that you can use, Storybird, but because of the time, I cannot really show you. But this Storybird website's also a good web that you can use to teach your student like writing, reading, especially writing and reading, because the student can write collaboratively and they have reading activity interactive between students or between member of the Storybird. You can also teach creativity and also building network there. Okay, now I'm jumping to this one. Don't forget social media. Okay, your students, most of your students are millennial generation. They are very close to social media, especially Instagram, for example. So you can also make use of Instagram, yeah, for your teaching platform. Sometime you can online through IG Live, for example, if you are teaching high school student, and they would love to do it. Okay. All right, actually there are some link here that at the moment I cannot show you. This is some activities that I did in my class in the context of using social media for my class. So I make use of YouTube, for example, for students' presentation. Okay, I also asked them to do it in Instagram, for example. This was when I taught my student caption writing. So I asked them to post it in Instagram. And then they tag me Instagram. We interact using Instagram at that time. All right, Ibu Santi, I think that's all for the presentation. Yeah, I give it back to you. Thank you for listening. Hope it's useful for all of us. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you so much for the presentation, Bapak. It was so informative and enlightening for us, especially how we can be creative, innovative in this pandemic era. And you have mentioned about the 3M, media, method, and materials. And you also have given us so many powerful and also accessible links for the teachers and also students who wants to learn English more. We have like edpuzzle.com, we have newsinlevel.com, Learn English by British Council, and so many teaching ideas that we can use. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm noticing some questions from YouTube and also from Zoom. If you want to start asking question, you may do so. And please use the format hashtag /your name and then /affiliation and then give me your question. Okay, while waiting for the participants in Zoom, I think we can start to read the question from YouTube. So Bapak, I think you have so many greetings, nice greetings and appreciation from our participants in YouTube. Yeah. So many appreciation, and also I've seen many questions. Let me read it for you, Bapak.
Okay.
Let me see. Wait. Okay, so the first question is from Made Suambo. Made Suambo from IKIP Saraswati. How to increase the motivation of the students in online learning? So how, as a teacher, we can motivate our students?
Okay. All right, thank you. Very good questions. Because one of the problems in online learning is, yes, that is about motivation. Yeah, some students feel really bored. Even us as teachers also sometimes feel bored of teaching online all the time, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. One thing that is very important in online learning is called as interactivity. Okay. So make sure you are interacting with your students well. Do not be like a robot. Yeah, you are teaching and you are explaining lesson, and then your student listening to you for 1 hour even more, of course going to be bored. Okay. So how can you motivate your student? The simplest thing is greet everyone from at the beginning of your class. Mention their name. Good morning, Santi, for example. How are you today? Yeah. Okay, when you mention your student's name, they will feel personalized and they will feel happy. They will feel appreciated. Okay. So make sure, if possible, mention everyone's name at the beginning, for example, just like what you did in your normal class when you are, you know, taking attendance, okay? Yeah, quickly mention like Santi and then Arfi or Mary, how are you today? Are you all good there? Okay, greet your student. And as well as well, while you are presenting your topic or your material, so sometime in your presentation, you need to make sure whether your student are listening to you, just like what I did. Are you still with me, for example? So just to make sure that you are not talking or you're not speaking alone. And then another important thing is what we call by feedback, okay? So do not like be teachers who love, okay, assigning students to do lots of projects, but after that, they never give any feedback. You know what happened to my daughter? I have 3 school-age children, okay? And one of them is still going in junior high school. And every day, her teacher assigned her to report her memorization, Quran memorization, hafalan Quran, right? So after Maghrib, what she did is posting her new memorizing Quran or new memorized Quran to her teacher or her ustad through WhatsApp. But every time she post her video memorization, she looked unhappy. And I asked her, what happened, Wafa? Her name is Wafa. What happened, Wafa? You look unhappy. Yeah, because the ustads only read the post. So no feedback at all, only keep silent. And student can see whether you have read the message, right? By looking at the, you know, the 2 blue centang. Okay, so they can see whether you have read it or not. So why don't you just simply, for example, give thumb up for your students. Okay, 2 thumbs up for you, or say something like very good, well done, yeah, much better, fantastic, yeah, very good, excellent, good student, keep up good work, thing like that. And you know, I always say this to my student, also my colleague. Our words as teachers are like magic. So whatever we see is going to impact our students. So if we say positive words to our students, it's going to impact your student positively. And I believe this simple positive word would motivate your student. And then one day, my daughter looked very happy. And I asked, you look happy today. What happened? Yes, because my ustad said, Mumtaz, yeah. So Mumtaz means very good, right? So she was really happy only by one simple word, maybe from teacher side, Mumtaz. So make sure you provide feedback to your student. And if you want to go further, maybe you can have like individual consultation. If you think some students are really unmotivated, they might have personal problem, you can have like personal interaction, asking her what's happening with you, why you never come up to my class. We don't know what's happening today, everyone, because people are dealing with difficult situation. Maybe some of their families are impacted by COVID, we don't know. So we have also to give more empathy to our students at the moment. So do not judge them to be like naughty student only not attending your class online. They might have some serious problem, we don't know. Okay, so give more empathy to our students. I think that's some ideas, Bu Santi. Thank you. Give it back to you.
Thank you so much. Yes, I do really agree, sir. So interactiveness and also empathy is something that we need as a teacher to engage more with our students, right?
Yeah.
So we have one more question from YouTube, sir.
Yeah.
So ladies and gentlemen, our dear participants, so we will have more Q&A time session. So please ask as many questions as you need, because we have enough time for our speakers responding to your question. So the next question is from, wait a minute, sir. We have from, which one? Wait, it got lost here. But I think we can try to this one. From Herming Indrajaya, sir.
Okay.
The methods have been varied, but most problem faced is time. Some of the students cannot submit the test on time. Any experience about that, sir? And how, as a teacher, we can deal with students' management, time management?
Okay. I think one of the words that we need to, what is it? We need to remember during this difficult situation is be flexible. Do not be too rigid, because our student might have different situation, might have different problems. So late submission, for example, it can be caused by some reasons. Okay, it's not only about students are lazy, for example, it's not because of they are not disciplined, but you know, maybe some technical problems. You know, if your students are living in rural area, for example, they might have problem with internet connection. I've heard some student fell, not some, but a student fell down from a tree somewhere in Indonesia. Why? Because he has to find a location where he can have good internet connection. And the only location that he can do is by a location where he can, where he has to climb a tree. So, you know, the higher our position will be better the connection. And you know what happened when he climbed up the tree, he fell down. And we don't want it to happen to our student, because at this situation, safety is number one. That is the first priority. So please be flexible. If your student are late in submission, you can you can personally contact him. Hello, how are you there? Are you okay? Yeah. And what's happening with you, by the way? I've seen in Google Classroom you were late in submitting your assignment. What happened? So ask them first. Be emphatic, as I said before. Okay. I think that's all.
Okay, thank you, sir. So being flexible is also one of a kind that we should address as a teacher. And then the next question, sir. So actually you have so many questions here from YouTube and also Zoom chat. I think we can start by, we can continue to Zoom chat. Let me see. We have question from SMA Negeri 2 Bantaeng from Ibu Nur Hikmah. Good morning, Bu Nur Hikmah. How to motivate students to join the online learning? So sometimes for the students, it's hard for them to believe that this online learning will also be fun as the offline learning. So what do you think, sir? How we can, as a teacher, make our students believe that, hey guys, it's also fun, trust me. What do you think, sir?
Yeah, I think the question is similar to previous question, right, about motivating students. And I have answered some ideas like interactivity, all right, and then feedback, all right, empathy, okay. And another idea or another important thing that I think really important also for us to do in motivating students is, variety, yeah, variety of the activity. So as I have mentioned before, we should know lots of alternative in approaching our students. So vary the activity. Do not only stick on one platform. Because if you are sticking only on one platform, that would make your student feel bored. So they know already, oh, tomorrow Zoom again. Tomorrow Zoom again. I don't like Zoom, for example. So vary the activity. Sometimes you can reach your students through WhatsApp. That is the simplest one. Okay. Sometimes you in the morning in WhatsApp you can have voice note and greet your student there and just record your voice, right? Hi everyone, how are you today? Are you all good? And then send it to their WhatsApp in the morning. And they would love to see your voice. Okay, voice note. Okay. But the next day, yeah, you can ask them, yeah, let's see now in Google Meet, for example. You know the link, right? Or the next day, you do it in Zoom meeting. There's another application that now we can use, for example. So vary the activity. And sometime you can also assign them to have collaborative activity. Yeah, but for example, in Zoom, we have breakout room, right, in Zoom. So do not only have lecturing all the time in Zoom. You are presenting, your student listening, they will be bored. But you can ask them, now time for you to discuss this topic. I will break you to several rooms. Okay, wait, that I will break you in a minute. And later, your student can work in smaller group. Or you can ask them to do a small project, yeah, like creating video online, but on a basis of group. And then use their, as I said before, link it to their social media. You know, our high school student, at least they have one Instagram account, for example. Think how can you make use of their life, yeah, to your online learning activity. So variety, yeah, variety of activity, because by the end of the day, our life need variation, right? If you like rendang, for example, by the way, I come from Padang as well, okay? So you know rendang, yeah. Right, Bu Santi? Rendang is very well known food from Padang, right? Most people love rendang. Yes, rendang is delicious. But if you eat rendang all the time, all days, it's going to be boring, right? The same case happens to your online learning activity. So think, what is new? This is why teachers should reflect every day, right? My class today is not that interesting. What I've done wrong? Okay, you think. And then after thinking, you might have new ideas. Okay, tomorrow I'm going to do this. Or tomorrow I'm going to do game. You know, there are some online games that you can do. You know Kahoot? Have you heard of Kahoot, Bu Santi?
Yeah.
Yeah, Kahoot is a web that you can have an interactive online.
Yes, yes sir. It's an interesting
online game. So you can do things like that. Variety is the key. That's it, Bu Santi.
Okay, noted, sir. So variety. So actually, we have so many ideas from Pak Afrianto. Next question. I think I see hands here. So someone is raising hands. Maybe let's try. Which one? Okay, from BI IMA 2020. BI IMA. Do you have any question? Yeah, hello. Are you with us? Ima, BI Ima. Okay, while waiting. Oh yeah. Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, Miss.
Hello, Ima. Can you introduce yourself? Can you introduce yourself? Do you have any question for the first presenter? Do you have any question? I don't think so, yeah? Okay, now let's move to the next question. Bapak, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm very glad to meet you in this webinar. It's amazing. Thank you. From Ibu Rosi, Ibu or Bapak, Rosi from Padang, Universitas Putra Indonesia Padang. I teach introduction to literature. My question is how to integrate the education character in learning process during this virtual setting. because in this virtual setting, the teacher cannot meet the students, you know, face to face. So how do we deal with that, sir?
It's a hard question.
Indeed.
Character, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah, talking about characters, that means talking about the affective domain of our students' development, right? So it can be about responsibility, it can be about respect, right? And respect the others, and then tolerance, for example. It's about character, right? It's about integrity, about discipline. And it's really, I think, some ideas that are not, that I'm thinking now, for example, for being respect, to teach your student respect, for example, you can set up a clear rules of your online learning from the beginning. Yeah. For example, in my class, for example, one of the rule is when we have face-to-face interaction like this, the default is first you have to switch on your video. That is the default rule. And you have to mute your audio, okay? Unless you are asked to say something. So this way we teach our students to respect the teachers and to respect their friends. Because sometimes if we don't say it explicitly, you know, in online learning, some students simply switch off their video and they are escaping. They are doing something else. They go to their bedroom, for example. Yeah, so they don't respect their teachers. So this is one of the ways, I think, in online learning, set up new rules. And if you want to teach your students about integrity, for example, being honest, especially in during exam, I think one of the challenges in online learning is conducting exam, especially a test, because we are not really sure whether the student do by themselves. We cannot really control whether they do some, you know, searching in Google, for example, to answer the questions, or maybe somebody else sit beside them. We don't really know. So tell them at the beginning, yes, I cannot see you, everyone. But one thing that you have to do now is, again, switch on your video when you are doing this online. And in my case, by the end of the day, I would say, now I'm trusting you as a good person. I trust you that you will it by yourself. Do not cheat, do not search for the questions online, okay? And above all, Allah is with us now. Allah, you can lie to me, but you cannot lie to Allah, right? Because Allah will always see us wherever we are. So at least we are trying to remind them to be honest, yeah, to have what we call the integrity. And one thing that I'm going to remind my students in my class is, if it is especially about essay, for example, or let's say writing and teaching writing, for example, we ask the students, right, to produce some text or some paragraphs or an essay. One of the policies in my class I apply, whether online or offline, is all the same. This that I apply what I call by zero tolerance for plagiarism. Okay, zero tolerance for plagiarism. So I remind my student about this all the time. And if I catch you committed to plagiarism, no, sorry. You will be automatically get zero for this subject and you will be automatically failed. It's not me failing you, it's you yourself failing you because you are committed to plagiarism. And I remind my student, I'm an experienced teacher, by the way, students. So I got lots of application to identify the originality of your work. So I know how it plays. I mean, do not play with me because I have lots of games to understand your game, for example. Thing like that. I'm reminding my student to be honest. Okay, depending on what character that you mean, Ibu, okay? If you are teaching your student about responsibility, for example, okay, you can set up the deadline, okay? Deadline of your project, of a certain project in Google Classroom. And the good thing of Google Classroom, it can, we can set up the deadline and this, we can identify automatically which student have submitted on time or in time or late, okay? So you can have policy like, everyone when you are late for no reasons, for example, maybe you will get minus score. It's up to you. But again, this is pandemic. We cannot really rigid with this policy. That's why you have to be empathy at the same time. But at least we are trying still to teach our students about characters, yeah, during this online learning. So we are not only transferring knowledge, because if it is only about transferring knowledge, we cannot, I mean, we don't have really to explain something today, everyone, because we can just guide our student. Can you please now find the answer of this question? Go to Google and then do some searching. They will come up with lots of ideas to answer your question. So if it is only about knowledge. And our responsibility as teachers is also educating our students. And one of them is to develop their character, right? And still we have to work and find some ways. And I think these are some ideas that I've done in my class as well. Okay. Thank you, Busanti, that's all.
Okay, thank you, sir. So we still have one more question. Let's take it from Zoom. The question comes from Nurani Ike, Guru Ike, from SMP N1 Warung Asem Batang, Middle Java. How to use WA group for learning so that it is more effective, since my students get many obstacles when using another media of learning except WhatsApp group. So how, as a teacher, we can make this WhatsApp group be more impactful and also fun for the students, sir? Do you have any ideas, sir?
Yeah, I know WhatsApp group is very popular, and some research shows that this is now the most popular platform that teachers use during pandemic, especially in Indonesia. And we understand, because this is the most popular application as well, not only for teaching, but also for our daily communication. We can use it as one of the platforms, but I would suggest if you can vary with other platform would be better, I think. Because the problem with WhatsApp is not really like LMS. Okay, we cannot really manage our activity in that WhatsApp. For example, if you post a material, okay, it can be easily, it can be easily forgotten by your student, because when there is a new information, it will going up, right? And then if there is somebody say hello, and then the material will go up higher, and then student will sometimes student do not really pay attention to the materials. However, yes, that's one of the platform we can use. So if you think that this is the only application at the moment that you can use, first set up the rules. Again, the rules should be clear from the beginning. For example, when you start a class, yeah, make sure everybody knows the procedure. For example, you are starting your class by sending voice note, for example, okay? So you greet your student, assalamualaikum everyone, how are you today? I hope you are all good. And then post your voice note. And then the rule is, when you get a voice note from me, everyone, please respond immediately. Okay, so now you are waiting the response for 2 minutes, for example. The response can be either in written form or can be in voice note as well, which is okay, maybe, which is okay. Acceptable, depending on you. If you ask your student only to write it, just write it. Or if you allow them to have a voice note as well, just use voice note. And then after 2 minutes, you motivate your student. So again, you are recording your voice note. Okay, student, today we are going to discuss, if you are an English teacher, we are going to discuss the difference between present perfect and past tense, for example. And remember, this topic is very important, because there are many people are confused with the difference between past tense and present perfect, because these two seem to happen in the past time. All right. So make sure everybody listen to my explanation after this. So you're trying to motivate and post again. Okay. So never let the student to interrupt you with any unrelated information until you post your materials, or until you finish your class. Okay? And then explain. But the problem is, in WhatsApp, of course, you cannot do voice note all the time. Okay? So for explanation, because it takes time, sometimes it takes longer, I think the alternative is you try to find a web or a link in YouTube, for example, related to your topic. And then you can later simply ask your student to watch the material by them first. So for the explanation about the difference between past tense or simple past tense and present perfect, everyone, please watch this link. And after watching this link, okay, please summarize, yeah, by writing the differences between these two tenses after you watch the materials here in WhatsApp group, for example. So the step must be clear, okay? And student must know what are the steps, okay? I suggest you, Ibu or Bapa, who are asking about this, I think I found there is a good link in YouTube, steps by step of teaching using WhatsApp. I think you can later learn from the link, okay? Or you can simply now search in YouTube, yeah, how to conduct online class using WhatsApp application. And I believe you will find some ideas there, okay? But I suggest you, or I encourage you to also to vary, as I said, to find another platform that you can combine with WhatsApp. So in my case, I'm not saying WhatsApp is not used in my class. I ask my student to have their WhatsApp group as well, but I'm not using it as the main platform. I use learning management system like Google Classroom, yeah, to manage my class, but later I integrate with some other platform. It can be WhatsApp group, it can be Zoom, it can be Google Meet. Sometimes I use Google Slides, sometimes I use Google Doc, sometimes I use Kahoot, sometimes I use YouTube. So it should be rich with some alternatives, yeah. All right, Ibu Santi, I don't know whether it answered my it answered the question. I think that's all. Thank you again for all the questions.
Yeah, okay, thank you so much for Pak Afrianto, the PhD. Actually, we still have so many questions from Zoom and also YouTube, but I'm sorry because that's the time okay. For Q&A is it's enough. And Bapa, we have so many guests here. I should say hi to the participants from all over Indonesia. We have from Jawa Tengah, we have from Kalimantan, we have from Bogor, and many other cities from Indonesia. Thank you for joining, because we still have one more nice speaker after this. So thank you so much for Bapa Afrianto, PhD, who has given us so many things to survive learning English in this pandemic era. So we will listen to special session, and of course it will be interesting and motivating because our next presenters will be delivering the topic of experiencing learning English in Europe. The next presenter is Ibu Arofiatu Sedia, MPD. She is an English lecturer of UIN Malang. She is also a BIPA teacher for Filipinos, and also she is an Erasmus Mundus awardee. To know her better, please watch the video profile of Ibu Arofiatu Sedia, MPD.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Good morning. Good morning, Bu Arafiatus.
Good morning. Is it clear my voice, Miss?
Yes. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much for the time and the opportunity for me, the Honorable Director Bapak Ridwan, and also the Dean Ibu Astrid, and the Head of Department Bapak Muhammad Fatoni. Thank you so much. I am here to be invited to be the second speaker. I will explain about my experience, how to get the scholarship, and I will tell other experience during my scholarship period. But before I ask, sorry, maybe I will mix my language in English and Bahasa Indonesia. I will start to open my slide. Can you see my slide?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But pardon me, ma'am. I think you need to turn off, I don't know, maybe the air conditioner or the fan near you, because there is a humming voice coming to our Zoom. Do you have like air conditioning on or fan? Maybe you need to turn it off for a while, because the humming voice keep coming.
Okay, no air conditioner, but I think my mom voice like okay. Reciting Holy Quran.
While waiting for Ibu Arafiatus, ladies and gentlemen and dear participants, I have, oh yeah.
Okay, is it no more noisy? Bu Santi? Okay, hello, for the voice?
Yeah?
Sudah jelas ya? Halo, Ibu?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear now?
I still can hear the humming voice here, ma'am. Maybe you need to turn off the air conditioner, or maybe the fan near you. No? Or maybe the headset? Do you use headset, ma'am?
No, no.
No, no fans, do you?
No fan.
Okay. Okay, then go on, ma'am. Yeah, the show must go on. Oh, yeah, yeah, please try. Please try, ma'am. Okay. Okay, let me take 1 minute while you try your speaker, ma'am. I have to announce for all the participants from Zoom and YouTube, you will have, for three lucky participants who have give questions, you can have OVO voucher 50,000 rupiahs from the committee for the three best questions. So make sure that after this, you give your best questions to Ibu Arafiatus. And I think she's ready with us now. Let's check.
Hello, yeah. Hello. Ibu? Is it clear? Yeah.
Okay, that's better. That's better. Okay.
Baik, terima kasih Bu Santi. Before, I really want to say thanks to Bapak Afrianto Daud, the first speaker. I do appreciate and the informative and useful information about your teaching method and media, because like during now, like I feel stuck yeah with the online class. I use only Zoom and then Kahoot, Quizzes, and World Wall Net. Yeah, itu. So I got more information, useful information from Bapak Afrianto Daud. Thank you so much, Bapak.
Okay.
Okay, terima kasih. Yeah, as you can see from my slide in the first page, I write here success is my right. Sukses itu hakku. Mungkin teman-teman, Bapak Ibu audience sudah sangat familiar ya dengan kalimat ini, maybe from Andri Wongso. But actually I heard the first about this sentence from my
teacher when I was in Islamic boarding school in Pesantren Putri Al-Mawadah, Coper Jetis, Ponorogo. So one of my teacher, the name is Bapak Almarhum Imam Budiono Sahal. When he was teaching and he delivered this message for the student, like sukses itu hakmu, kejar hak itu, dan tidak ada yang instan, semuanya butuh proses. Ya, memang benar seperti itu adanya ya, sukses itu memang harus dikejar dan ada prosesnya, tidak instan. Okay, as the CV before, I was the Erasmus awardee. So I got the Erasmus scholarship twice for exchange staff for 1 month in Lublin University of Technology in Poland. And the second one, I got master exchange program at Czech Republic, the Brno City. This is the University of Masaryk. Okay. For your information, apa itu beasiswa Erasmus Plus? Dulunya beasiswa ini Erasmus Mundus, tapi mulai 2017 diganti menjadi Erasmus Plus dan lingkupnya lebih luas lagi, tidak hanya dalam bidang pendidikan, tetapi juga kegiatan pemuda dan olahraga. Oke, Erasmus Plus. Jadi Erasmus Plus adalah program Uni Eropa, EU, di bidang pendidikan, pelatihan, pemuda, dan olahraga untuk periode 2014 sampai 2020. Jadi ini beasiswa penuh dari dana hibah Uni Eropa. Terkait tiket, SPP, uang saku, semuanya dibayar oleh, didanai oleh EU. Dan beasiswa ini mengembangkan serta memupuk kerjasama antara EU dan EU, jadi tidak hanya EU dan Asian countries, tetapi sesama European Union countries dan EU international cooperation with partner countries. Jadi salah satunya partner countries Indonesia. Untuk for the program, jadi banyak yang ditawarkan untuk beasiswa ini. Pertukaran untuk S1, S2 dan S3. Lalu program full degree, ini sangat umum ya, semua beasiswa fokusnya pada full degree S2 dan S3. Sangat jarang full degree untuk S1. And then for scholar atau para akademisi peneliti. Dan untuk karyawan di universitas, contohnya mungkin karyawan di bagian perpustakaan, di kemahasiswaan, keuangan, dan lain sebagainya. Oke. Okay.
Nah, hello, Ibu Arufiatus.
Ya.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Can you slide show your presentation so we can see your slides more clearly?
Full screen.
Ya.
Yeah. Seperti ini. Oke, saya
yes,
lanjutkan.
That's
good. Bisa. Oke, selanjutnya. Negara yang tergabung dalam program Erasmus Plus. Jadi tidak semua EU countries itu termasuk dalam program Erasmus Plus. Di sini ada sekitar 28. Baru ini saya dapat update Brexit ya, UK sudah tidak termasuk dalam program Erasmus Plus. Jadi ada 27 member state dalam program countries. And the partner countries ada 13 poin di sini. Dan Indonesia termasuk dalam poin ke-6 ini, selected Asian countries. Kita di sini. Jadi teman-teman silakan yang ingin pergi ke Austria, Finland, France, Turki, nah itu juga bisa termasuk dalam program Erasmus Plus. Nah, untuk persyaratan beasiswa Erasmus Plus, ini pastinya yang pertama teman-teman menyiapkan paspor. Walaupun belum tahu mau apply kemana, di mana, dan kapan, tapi teman-teman sudah, oh poin satu, paspor saya sudah punya nih, kunci utamanya, paspor untuk pergi ke luar negeri. Nah itu paspor silakan dipersiapkan dari sekarang sebagai langkah awal. Yang kedua, aplikasi daring. Jadi beasiswa Erasmus ini secara online, secara daring. Jadi untuk setiap programnya mempunyai tautan dan teman-teman langsung terdaftar di tautan tersebut, program yang teman-teman pilih. Yang tidak kalah penting itu motivation letter atau surat motivasi. Di sini poin yang paling besar, tidak harus panjang lebar, mungkin hanya 1 sampai 1,5 halaman. To explain your motivation, kenapa Anda ingin belajar di Eropa, di kampus itu, dan di program itu. Pasti setiap program punya keunikan masing-masing, teman-teman boleh relate your motivation with the program, with the countries. Dan ini poinnya yang paling besar biasanya dalam penilaian. Yang keempat, tidak kalah penting dan mutlak untuk semua beasiswa luar negeri, itu language requirement, jadi TOEFL atau IELTS. Untuk Erasmus, TOEFL masih accepted ya. Tapi secara umum, memang biasanya seperti beasiswa-beasiswa yang lain, itu minimal 550. Dan IELTS, tergantung kampusnya, bisa 6, 6,5, 7, itu tergantung kampusnya. Dan yang kelima itu surat rekomendasi, recommendation letter, bisa meminta dari orang yang benar-benar mengenali Anda atau seperti dosen pembimbing atau pimpinan di kantor. Atau ada cerita unik, teman saya meminta rekomendasi kepada bapak kosnya. Jadi rekomendasi itu kan nantinya dari pihak Erasmus akan mengontak. Jadi silakan teman-teman memilih orang yang benar-benar mengenali bapak ibu sekalian. Yang keenam ini administrasi seperti ijazah dan transkrip nilai. Dan yang ketujuh CV Europass. Untuk beasiswa Erasmus Plus ini untuk CV formatnya sudah ada format dari sananya ya, CV Europass. Ini teman-teman bisa mengunggah, mencari di Google, dan ada juga instruksi how to fill it. Nah ini juga karena saya dari Erasmus Malang, kami punya komunitas @erasmusmalang. This is the Instagram account. Ini saya tulis di sini, baca dulu baru bertanya. So, tahun 2017 sampai 2018 saya menjadi perwakilan city representative untuk alumni Erasmus di Kota Malang. Kami sering dengan para alumni lain itu mengadakan pameran-pameran di kampus-kampus di Malang, di Surabaya. Nah, itu banyak orang yang tertarik dengan beasiswa ini, tetapi juga banyak yang bertanya hal-hal yang sangat umum. Jadi teman-teman silakan dibaca dulu hal-hal yang umum seperti apa itu beasiswa Erasmus, bagaimana persyaratannya, itu kan sudah tersedia di website ya. Jadi silakan bertanya hal-hal yang lebih teknis atau spesifik seperti misal saya sudah membuat motivation letter nih, saya mau bertanya nih kepada para alumni, kurang apa ya? Nah, itu lebih bagus untuk ditanyakan ya. Dan juga mungkin tentang saya sudah mengunduh download aplikasinya dan ada beberapa poin yang tidak paham. Oh, saya bertanya pada alumni, ini bagaimana sih? Mungkin ada beberapa poin yang belum jelas, itu boleh ditanyakan juga. Oke, ini terkait requirement di teknis ya. Nah, ini pastinya sangat klasik ya teman-teman dan sangat familiar, the iceberg illusion. Sukses itu ini seperti iceberg. Jadi yang orang lihat itu hanya di atas ini, tapi di dalamnya, di bawahnya itu orang kurang memperhatikan. Hanya kita-kita yang menjalani yang tahu. Di dalamnya memang kita bertemu banyak kegagalan, failure, sacrifice, pengorbanan, pastinya kerja keras, dedikasi yang sangat tinggi untuk mencapainya, dan disiplin. Tapi yang orang lihat memang hanya sukses. Mungkin benar apa yang ada di benak orang. Kalau semisal saya posting di Instagram saya seperti ini, pastinya saya ingin share, I want to share good things ya. Tidak mungkin saya share something yang scary, seperti saya pernah tersesat di Belanda, saya pernah kecopetan di Barcelona. Itu sangat tidak bagus untuk dibagikan. Jadi di Instagram saya mungkin hal-hal yang bisa dilihat orang hal-hal yang indah-indah seperti ini. Padahal di dalamnya untuk mendapatkan beasiswa itu many failure, many sacrifice, dan memang membutuhkan usaha. Oke, ini salah satunya usaha yang saya lakukan. Yang harus dilakukan utamanya adalah action. Action, daftar. Jadi kalau ditanya berapa kali sih daftar, gimana sih caranya kok bisa mendapatkan beasiswa? Mungkin teman-teman yang scholarship hunter sudah merasakan ya. Jadi tidak, saya bukan yang sekali dua kali langsung dapat beasiswa. Di sini beberapa email-email yang kegagalan-kegagalan saya cantumkan di sini, ada yang rejected, ada yang reserve, dan akhirnya saya mendapatkan surat cinta dari Eropa, program Erasmus Plus itu awarded. Jadi mungkin kalau di total itu sekitar 20-30 kali mendaftar, awalnya rejected, and then naik pangkat, naik jabatan sedikit menjadi reserve, cadangan, sampai bosan mendapatkan email cadangan, dan akhirnya memang kalau kita tidak berhenti berusaha, daftar terus, memperbaiki, oh kesalahannya ini, pada email pertama kesalahannya kurang di nilai TOEFL, oke, belajar TOEFL lagi, terus di email kedua motivation letter kurang nyambung, for example, jadi dibenahi, jadi ada notes-notesnya ya, kenapa tidak diterima. Ini memang harus never give up, tidak putus asa, sampai akhirnya mendapatkan awarded. Action untuk poin pertamanya, dan kedua ya memang benar never give up, hargai proses. Jadi selama mendaftar gagal, itu tetap berbuat kegiatan positif di sini ya. Contohnya, oh saya mau memperbaiki CV, I want to update my CV dengan kegiatan-kegiatan yang positif. Ikut volunteer atau mengikuti seminar. Ya, intinya mengupdate CV, upgrade juga CV-nya. Dan yang tidak kalah penting, doa orang tua itu nomor satu sih menurut saya, karena mungkin usaha sudah berusaha semaksimal mungkin, tapi tanpa doa orang tua sangat kurang ya menurut saya, karena saya yakin kemarin kok bisa ya saya lolos. Oh, poin terbesarnya ada di poin keempat ini, doa orang tua. Dan ini salah satu kelas saya waktu di Ceko, di Masaryk University, Faculty of Education. Di sini saya orang Asia sendiri ya, dan teman-teman kebanyakan dari Ceko. Tetapi untungnya ini adalah international class, jadi fully bahasa Inggris, fully English. Teman-teman nanti semisal interested to register for Erasmus Plus program, sebaiknya mengenal dulu kampusnya dan fakultasnya, apakah mereka punya international program. Jadi beberapa teman, contohnya di Portugal, itu ada kampusnya tidak ada international class. Jadi mereka seperti alien, kelas dengan Google Translate, mencoba menangkap apa yang disampaikan dosen, Pak dosen. Jadi dipastikan memang kelasnya ada international program. Jadi benar-benar di sini walaupun kebanyakan orang Ceko, tapi mereka fully English. Karena Eropa bukan English speaking countries ya. Jadi memang harus diperhatikan tentang international program. Untuk tantangan pastinya saya mengalami cross culture, budaya yang sangat berbeda, kebiasaan yang sangat berbeda, makanan. Alhamdulillah saya masih menemukan nasi di sana. Karena di sana ada orang-orang Vietnam untuk di Brno, Ceko itu. Ada Asian market, orang-orang Vietnam. Saya masih menemukan tempe, tahu, tapi sangat mahal ya, tidak sama harganya. Dan sayur-sayuran juga masih ada di sana. The third one about the weather. Pastinya sangat berbeda karena kita dari negara dengan dua cuaca dan kita datang ke negara dengan empat musim. Dan waktu itu saya bertemu dengan salju ya, musim salju. Memang salah satu tantangan juga untuk cuaca, harus adaptasi. Lalu yang keempat, international class. Saya bilang tantangan di sini karena ketika saya akan berangkat ke Ceko, itu saya bisa tidak ya nanti di sana bersama teman-teman yang mungkin beberapa orang native. Itu mungkin salah satu tantangan yang saya rasa. Tapi ketika saya terjun langsung di sekolah, di kelas itu, oh ternyata saya tidak bodoh-bodoh amat. Jadi saya bisa mengikuti kelas dengan baik, dengan nilai yang bagus, alhamdulillah. Itu, dan sistem canggih pasti ya, karena kita dari developing countries come to developed countries, dan sistemnya mereka sudah online semuanya dengan metode-metode yang cukup canggih juga. And also language, bahasa. Ini di luar kelas, maksud saya dalam bahasa ini, kalau di kelas fully English, tapi untuk di luar saya bertemu dengan, mungkin saya tersesat, dan beberapa orang yang bukan orang-orang muda, yang bapak-bapak ibu tua, itu tidak bisa berbahasa Inggris. Jadi cukup menjadi tantangan untuk bahasa. Oke, tetapi selain ada challenge, saya menemukan hal-hal positif lainnya seperti international network. Dengan pergi ke belahan dunia lain, bertemu orang-orang yang bermacam-macam, pastinya saya merasakan international network. Satu kelas dengan banyak teman dari berbagai negara, dengan berbagai background, dengan berbagai ya perbedaan ya. Lalu kedua, saya bangga sebagai orang Indonesia, I introduce the culture of Indonesia. Ketika berada di negara lain, saya merasa, oh Indonesia ini memang kaya akan budaya ya, tentang tarian, tentang lagu, tentang alat musik, atau bahkan tentang makanan. Itu sangat saya rasakan kalau Indonesia ini benar-benar detail tentang budaya. Makanan seperti nasi tumpeng, oh warnanya kuning, ada arti tersendiri. Nah itu saya coba bertanya pada beberapa negara lain, ada nggak makanan yang punya cerita sedetil nasi tumpeng? Nah itu saya belum menemukan ya yang sedetil history of nasi tumpeng. Lalu yang ketiga, berkesempatan mengajar di SD Ceko. Nah, karena saya dari Faculty of Education, salah satu subjek yang saya ambil practice, teaching practice. Jadi saya mengajar di beberapa elementary di Czech Republic. Salah satunya saya mengenalkan tentang wayang. Ini wayang. Di sana lebih informal ya untuk suasana, how to teach itu ya lebih informal, tidak ada memakai seragam, dan kelas seperti sangat santai sekali. Guru, budaya berbeda ya, guru duduk di atas meja menjelaskan materi itu sudah biasa. Oke, yang selanjutnya, the next, metode baru dalam pembelajaran. Pastinya saya menemukan, oh berbeda ya, di Indonesia seperti ini, di Ceko seperti ini.
I'm sorry, Bu Arufiatus. Halo. Halo, yeah. Ma'am. You still have four more minutes.
Okay.
You still have 4 more minutes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Saya lanjutkan untuk the last point here, hidup mandiri ya. Karena jauh dari keluarga, jauh dari orang tua, to be independent itu otomatis. Okay. For the next slide, ini hanya sekedar intermezzo. Jadi apa yang orang lihat tentang sukses, mungkin karena oh mereka melihat saya jalan-jalan ke Santorini, ke Pisa, ke Eiffel. Nah, itu semuanya bonus. Tapi tetap utamanya untuk pergi ke Eropa itu utamanya adalah to study. Jadi saya mendapat beasiswa for one semester itu di Czech Republic untuk pertukaran mahasiswa S2. Pastinya ternyata di sana sistemnya tidak setiap hari kuliah. Ada yang sistemnya minggu genap, minggu ganjil. So that's why I can explore many cities in Europe. Dan seperti yang kita tahu, dalam peta Eropa itu sangat kecil. Saya di Ceko itu benar-benar di tengah. 2 jam itu sudah Austria, 5 jam itu sudah Hungary, lalu naik pesawat 1 jam sudah UK. Nah, itu sangat-sangat untuk lokasi ya. Jadi memang benar-benar di tengah. Jadi bisa pergi ke Jerman, Austria, and then Spain. Itu hanya untuk bonusnya, jalan-jalannya. Tapi tidak meninggalkan kewajiban untuk belajar itu tadi. Ini saya melakukan jalan-jalan setelah program selesai. Jadi setelah ujian akhir. Itu sharing dari saya, Mbak Santi dan teman-teman. Terima kasih untuk Facebook. Silakan teman-teman bisa kontak if you want to know more about Erasmus Plus program. Dan juga bisa teman-teman mengontak saya via Instagram @opiopiop atau via email arofiatus@yahoo.com. Thank you so much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Bu Arofiatus, for the insightful and informative discussion about experience in learning English in Europe. So, can you mute your microphone for a while, ma'am? Okay. Yes, hello. Thank you. Yeah. So, yeah. Hello, Bu Arofiatus. Bu Arofiatus.
Hello, I'm muted.
Okay. So, I think we have so many ideas, and also we get so motivated by. I've seen so many participants also responding to this issue, and I'd like to address this issue. But before that, I'd like, Bu Arofiatus, can you mute your microphone for a while, because the buzzing voice keep coming to. Yes, thank you. I'm sorry. So, Bu Arofiatus actually has guide us, and particularly for the students. Senior high school students and also universities who are also joining in our webinar today. And I'm sure that this topic is also motivating and interesting for them in order that they can be motivated to pursue their dreams higher and higher, and especially how they can study English in Europe or in other places. And as Bu Arofiatus has shown us, that there are so many scholarships that we can choose and we can adapt, we can select based on our capacity and also our opportunity. So that is why we brought up this topic into this webinar. Okay, now let's see the questions. Now we come to the Q&A sessions. Let's see from the Zoom chat. And I'd like to remind you, for all the participants, that we will choose 3 best questions, and they will get offer voucher 50,000 rupiah. I think that's also nice, yeah? Okay, let's see from Zoom chat. We have questions from Unugiri, Nikmatus Zuria, for Ibu Arofiatus. If we were accepted in this scholarship, is there a demand for us to maintain our achievement? So maybe she would like to ask you how to maintain the achievement, and if you have the scholarship, what are the requirements to survive having that scholarship?
until you finish your study. Can you explain to us, ma'am?
Okay, for Ibu Nikmah. Sorry, Ibu Nikmah.
Yeah, Ibu Nikmatus, Mbak Nikmatus. So she is one of our student from Unigiri.
Okay, thank you so much for your question, Nikmah. And then your question is how to maintain the achievement.
Yeah.
Okay. Jadi untuk beasiswa Erasmus ini, beasiswa full ya, didanai Uni Eropa. Jadi untuk setelah mendapatkan beasiswa, untuk kegiatan, untuk full degree itu tidak ada ikatan dinas ya. Tidak ada ikatan dinas harus terikat dari harus kembali ke institusi sebelumnya, itu tidak ada untuk beasiswa Erasmus. Jadi silakan setelah mendapatkan beasiswa Erasmus, teman-teman bisa berkarir di mana saja. Dan kami mempunyai komunitas di alumni ya, baik di Jakarta, di setiap kota, di Malang, ada juga di Kalimantan, ada juga di Surabaya, di Jawa Tengah. Nah itu alumninya itu sangat aktif, they are so active to create activities for the alumni, baik itu dalam improving ourselves, jadi seperti seminar itu internal untuk para alumni, or about networking stuff like work, how to find job, itu sesama alumni biasanya ada sharing seperti itu. Dan untuk biasanya kami juga berkumpul di Jakarta setiap tahunnya, itu kegiatan pre departure. Di situ kami juga bertemu dengan ambassador of Uni Eropa. Kami sharing. Nah, di situ juga bertemu para alumni dan para alumni yang sudah sangat hebat posisinya ya dalam dunia kerja. Jadi sharing satu sama lain untuk meningkatkan for our self development. Mungkin itu, atau ada pertanyaan lain, Bu Santi?
Thank you for the answer, ma'am. I'd like to remind once again for the participants that this session is actually designated especially for our students who are also actively joined into our webinar. We have university students from IAIN, from Unigiri also, from other university that is joining us in our Zoom and also YouTube. And I'm sure that this session is also interesting for you on how to get the experience from the presenters that has been learning in Europe. So the next question for Ibu Arufiatus from Salsabila, IAIN Jember, is there a limit, time limit to sign up for the Europe scholarship? I mean, when someone get failure to sign up. So can you explain to us once more about the time limitation for signing up Europe scholarship?
Okay, terima kasih. Thank you so much for the question. Jadi untuk beasiswa Erasmus itu, Erasmus Plus itu seperti payungnya ya. Di dalam payung Erasmus itu ada program-program yang sangat banyak sekali, dan setiap program itu bisa teman-teman daftar sesuai fakultas dan jurusannya. Uniknya Erasmus daripada beasiswa lainnya itu kami konsorsium. This is for full degree, lingkup full degree ya, S2 dan S3. Untuk beasiswa Erasmus, kampus mana yang ingin kita daftar sudah didesain oleh Erasmus itu sendiri. Contohnya saya ingin ikut program namanya Globet. Globet itu Faculty of Education. Dalam Globet itu sudah mempunyai konsorsium dari 4 negara. For example, Hungary, Austria, Swiss, and Swedia for example. And the coordinator is the Swiss one. Nah, di situ sudah terdesain kuliahnya akan pindah-pindah ke 4 negara itu. Ijazahnya akan ditandatangani oleh 4 rektor itu. Sudah didesain semester 1 Anda akan di negara ini, semester 2 di negara ini. Jadi untuk Erasmus kita tidak bisa memilih, oh saya pengen kuliah di Leiden University. Silakan mencari program yang ada Leiden University-nya. Jadi tidak bisa kita memilih kampusnya. Tapi menurut saya lebih baik silakan Anda mencari jurusan saya ini di program yang apa ya. Lalu saya mulai list, oh jurusan saya ada di program yang ini, yang ini, yang ini. Untuk masalah kampus, silakan teman-teman bisa melihat ranking-rankingnya. Semisal program yang ini kampusnya tidak terlalu bagus, silakan cari program yang lain yang menurut Anda kampusnya memang sesuai dengan yang Anda pilih. But for me, in my opinion, saya tidak melihat kampusnya karena memang kampusnya saya merasa itu sudah kampus-kampus yang sangat baik, develop. Jadi saya mencari jurusan saya di program yang mana saja. Lalu saya coba daftar ke program-program yang ada. For the time, untuk Erasmus tidak serentak dibuka di waktu yang bersamaan. Jadi tergantung pada program itu sendiri. Oh, program yang ini tahun ini tidak buka. Program yang ini setiap tahunnya buka di bulan Oktober. Program yang ini, ya jadi silakan memang harus dibaca satu per satu programnya. Biasanya Erasmus itu dimulai di akhir tahun ya, dan submitnya di Januari, Februari, nah itu untuk periodenya dan waktunya. Dan untuk usia, itu tidak ada batasan usia untuk beasiswa Erasmus, silakan S2, S3, tapi untuk full degree tidak ada ya, S1 tidak ada full degree, hanya ada pertukaran. Oke, itu Ibu. I think that's enough for my answer.
Okay, thank you so much for... Yeah, thank you so much, Bu Arifatus. So actually, we still have so many questions, and I think it comes from the students. Like I said before, that this topic is... I'm sure that this topic is interesting for the students, and we can prove it that there are so many questions. So you have to be ready, Bu Arifatus, for the questions that keeps coming here from the Zoom, especially. And let me take it one from... where is it? It keeps coming, Bu. So it's hard for me to, you know, to scroll up because it keeps coming here. So the next question is from which one? From UNP, from Universitas Negeri Padang, I guess. From Maratu Salihah, what is the best support and your big motivation to reach scholarship, and what's the key? Since I have, you know, up and down motivation and emotional issues here, so can you share something to us?
Okay, thank you Maratu Salihah for your question about motivation letter ya, karena itu memang PR sekali untuk menyiapkan motivation letter. Mungkin saya perlu 1-2 bulan untuk proofread by my friend, maybe
I'm sorry Ibu, not motivation letter, but your personal motivation to reach scholarship. Is it your parents? Is it your family, your friends, or what is it?
Okay, thank you. I think it's about motivation. Yeah, talking about motivation, so I put it on my motivation letter. So I related it by motivation letter.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, untuk
okay, go on, ma'am.
Untuk motivasi saya sendiri itu it started from when I was in third semester. Like I work as the part-timer at University Muhammadiyah Malang in international office. Dari situ lingkungan saya sudah sangat familiar dengan kegiatan-kegiatan internasional. Jadi saya menjadi part-timer di sana selama satu semester, and the next I work there for 8 years at international office in University of Muhammadiyah Malang. Lingkungan saya sangat mendukung sekali to bring me to the international atmosphere. Jadi saya mengelola dengan teman-teman masuk kantor, mengadakan kegiatan-kegiatan internasional, bertemu dengan banyak orang dari berbagai negara. Dan program utama kami selama saya bekerja di sana itu Erasmus Mundus. Jadi karena lingkungan sudah sangat mendukung dan saya sangat familiar dengan beasiswa Erasmus itu, saya sebagai koordinator yang mengurusi tentang Erasmus, ketika saya mengadakan pameran, orang akan bertanya, "Ibu udah kemana?" Nah, itu motivasi utama saya sih. Saya yang mengurus program itu di tempat saya bekerja, kenapa saya tidak bisa terjun langsung ke sana. Dan juga informasi itu kita harus mencari informasinya sendiri ya. Memang harus, untuk mencari beasiswa itu memang kita harus menjadwalkan waktu kita untuk duduk dan mencari-cari beasiswa. Jadi itu sih, sacrifice the time. Jadi mengorbankan waktu untuk mendapatkan apa yang kita inginkan. Di situ saya sudah ceritakan tadi, tidak sekali, dua kali, empat kali, lima kali, bahkan bertahun-tahun, akhirnya saya baru mendapatkan beasiswa Erasmus di tahun 2013 selama satu bulan as staff exchange, dan di tahun 2015 as student exchange untuk program master. Untuk motivasi saya sendiri itu lingkungan, dan tidak kalah pentingnya karena didukung doa orang tua tadi, for me, for myself, in my opinion. Itu. That's all for my answer, Ibu Santi. Kalau kuncinya tadi okay, saya jelaskan ya. Oke, okay, I want to add about the key. Jadi menanyakan kuncinya.
Thank you so much, Bu Arafiatus. So actually you still have
For the key for me, action. Jadi pertamanya itu memang harus daftar ya. Bu, ini ada saya juga membaca pertanyaannya, gimana sih cara dapatnya beasiswa, how to get the scholarship? Harus daftar, enggak 100% yang mendapatkan beasiswa itu yang daftar ya. ini tidak mungkin. Memang harus action dulu, tidak hanya bertanya, menyiapkan, dan dare to do it. Action, register, apply. Nah, itu sih. Okay, thank you, Ibu Ina.
Okay, I think we can take one more question here. It's come from Mbak, yeah, I guess Mbak Amriani from Politani Pangkep. What makes Erasmus different from the other scholarship, and how do you contribute to our country and to your institution after completing and returning to Indonesia? I guess this question is also, you know, the main questions in any motivation letter and any scholarship. Yeah, maybe some of our participants would like to apply for the scholarship. They have to answer this question, right, ma'am? So what are the contributions to our country and to the institution? Can you share your experience, ma'am? Thank you.
Okay, saya menjawab apa yang membuat Erasmus unik ya, yang soal pertama. Jadi sudah saya jelaskan tadi, Erasmus itu sistemnya konsorsium. Jadi untuk S2 dan S3, kita tidak hanya kuliah di satu negara, di satu kampus saja, tapi minimal itu ada dua negara, dan bahkan ada sampai 7 negara. Jadi teman-teman yang memang siap untuk yang ingin mendaftar beasiswa Erasmus, memang harus, konsepnya harus siap untuk pindah-pindah juga. Nah, dan pindah-pindah itu pun juga tantangannya tentang budaya. Satu bulan sudah tinggal di Ceko, lalu semester kedua harus sudah pindah lagi ke Belanda. Dan mereka walaupun sesama Eropa itu berbeda ya, untuk bahasa, lalu bahasa dan budaya mereka juga punya perbedaan. Jadi untuk beasiswa Erasmus konsorsium 1-7 negara, dan uniknya nanti ijazah tadi saya sampaikan akan ditandatangani oleh 2-7 rektor dalam satu ijazah, teman-teman. dan tidak ada ikatan dinas, itu tadi juga yang membuat Erasmus berbeda dengan beasiswa-beasiswa lain. Dan karena Eropa ini bukan English speaking countries, tapi kiblatnya itu UK ya. Jadi untuk beasiswa apapun lebih aman menggunakan IELTS daripada TOEFL. Kalau memang beasiswa Amerika, silakan TOEFL, IBT itu yang diutamakan. Tapi untuk Erasmus, TOEFL itu acceptable, tapi lebih baik, lebih aman itu menggunakan IELTS. Oke, untuk kontribusinya, saya pribadi setelah saya kembali dari program Erasmus Plus, lalu saya juga waktu itu masih bekerja dalam lingkup yang masih tentang Erasmus ya. Saya sebagai staff untuk program Erasmus Mundus di kampus saya. Di situ saya promoting the scholarship. Promoting, membuat kegiatan-kegiatan, promote the scholarship program tidak hanya di Malang, Surabaya, tetapi juga ke Jakarta, bertemu dengan banyak alumni lainnya, dan saya juga diberi kesempatan untuk mewakili Indonesia untuk pertemuan Erasmus secara global di Thailand, itu selama setiap tahunnya di Thailand ya. Jadi di sana bertemu dengan banyak alumni yang lebih luas, saya pulang bertemu dengan komunitas Indonesia, dan specifically dengan teman-teman Erasmus Malang. Jadi di situ kami membuat kegiatan tentang Erasmus, promoting, tidak hanya promoting saja ya, kegiatan apapun, talk show atau tentang social volunteering, nah itu biasanya kami lakukan di situ. Tapi untuk kontribusi personal terkait job profesional job sekarang, ya mungkin sebagai guru, sebagai dosen bahasa Inggris dan guru BIPA untuk program Filipina, saya menerapkan metode-metode yang saya dapatkan di sana, saya mix pengajaran di sana dan di Indonesia. Jadi of course we got new insight ya, dapat new information, new knowledge dari program pertukaran kita dari Erasmus. Oke, cukup itu Ibu Santi.
Oke, thank you so much Ibu Arofiatu. So actually you still have so many questions in lines from YouTube and also from Zoom. I'm sorry, I do apologize for the participants who have given us questions for Bu Arofiatu, but the time is up for question and answer session. I'm sorry. And if you want to know more or if you want to give questions to Ibu Arofiatu, you can contact her privately, and I think she has shared to us about her contact. And maybe Bu Arofiatu, you can also write down your number or your contact to the Zoom chat in order that our participants can contact you privately. So also for the participants who wants to ask questions, maybe you can also ask Mr. Siswoyo Hadi, who has given a response to the YouTube channel, and he was the ones who got the Erasmus scholarship. So he was also the awardee from Erasmus Mundus scholarship. You can ask him, yeah. Salam kenal Bapak. And so ladies and gentlemen, we come to the session for concluding remarks. Thank you so much for Ibu Arofiatu Sedia, MPD, and also Bapak Afrianto Del PhD, who has given us so many things here, informative and also applicable. So to conclude, the first presenter, Bapak Afrianto Del PhD, had given us some new ideas to be creative and innovative to learn English in this new normal era, and he also mentioned and shared to us so many websites that is impactful and also fun for our students to learn English. And also, we thank you so much to our second speaker, Ibu Arufiatu Sa'dia MPD. She has shared her experience learning English in Europe as our flyer. So actually, these two topics is actually has been stated or written in our flyer that our first speaker will give this topic, and the second speaker also have an interesting topics for especially for those who have dreams to pursue learning English in Europe. So, ladies and gentlemen, for the exit ticket, be patient because after this, our committee will share to you the exit ticket. So the exit tickets will serve as the attendance list. So we don't have another attendance list unless the one that you will have from YouTube and Zoom chat. Yeah, so be patient and just click the link and fill out your name, your emails correctly. Well, ladies and gentlemen, shall I express my gratitude for the two outstanding speakers, Bapak Afrianto and Ibu Arufiatu? Thank you so much for the inspiring discussion. Thank you, Bapak. Thank you, Ibu. Thank you. And thank you so much for the rector and the staff, the faculty member for the support. And then I should extend my appreciation for all participants for joining and participating with us either from Zoom or YouTube. And don't forget to fill out the exit ticket. Has it been shared? Yes. Okay. Yay, finally, I've got the exit ticket. I'm sure you are so happy to one of the things that you are waiting for. Yeah. Thank you for all participants for any inconvenience during the webinar session. And I should also thank you so much for the committee for having this webinar today. I know we were hard for this and we did it. Please allow me to mention some of the names here. We have Pak Tony, Miss Iin, Miss Nana, Pak Tauhid, Pak Edi, Pak Zain, Pak Wafa, Bu Ulfina, Mas Didi, Mas Andika, and all the names who have contributed to this webinar. You are amazing. It's my honor to be in this team. So before we close this session, let's take picture, especially for the participant from Zoom.
Bu Santi.
Yes.
Can I say special thank to Bu Iin as well today, because Bu Iin used to be actually my student in Padang. So good luck with your career there. Semoga lancar proses kelahiran anaknya. Sukses.
Yeah, thank you. On behalf of Miss Iin, say thank you, Bapak. Okay. Okay, shall we take picture for the Zoom participants? Okay. Team? Ready, team? Okay, for the participants in Zoom, you can turn on your video on. Please turn on your video on. Okay, turn on your video and give me your best smile. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Okay, next slide. The next slide. Give me your best smile. Okay, slide number 3. Be ready. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then the last slide. Okay, thank you. Have you got it? Yes. Good. So for all participants, we welcome you for the next webinar with us with another great topic. And thank you for joining. Wallahu muwafiq ila aqwamit thoriq. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you semua.
Thank you, Bapak.
Yeah. Pak Santi.
Thank you, Bapak. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum.